Vancouver, labor disruptions continued to add tension to BC's troubled casino industry, which was last week the subject of a scathing Auditor General's report on money laundering. Gateway Casinos is the company operating four Okanagan casinos where almost 700 workers collectively walked off the job last Friday. The company said the casinos, Cascades Kamloops, Cascades Penticton, Playtime Kelowna and Lake City Vernon, continue to operate with reduced hours during the labor disruptions. Members of BCGEU, including President Stephanie Smith, rally outside the office of the BCLC during the Hard Rock Casino strike. The Hard Rock strike has ended, and the union is now supporting a strike for casino workers in the Okanagan. Alex McKean, Star Metro Vancouver. The strike arrives on the tail of another casino industry strike at Hard Rock in Coquitlam, which reached a resolution last month when the parties, Great Canadian Gaming Corporation and the British Columbia Government and Service Employees Union, arrived at a tentative collective agreement through mediation. The Hard Rock strike reached its peak when the BCGEU, 1 month into the labor disruption, rallied outside the office of the BC Lottery Corporation and demanded that the government body intervene. The BCLC declined to participate, saying it wasn't a party in the dispute and therefore had no legal standing to intervene. Article continued below. 2 weeks later, the agency and the casino industry were under fire for an Auditor's General report that found the province's casinos had been used as laundromats for an infusion of dirty money, a report that has cast a shadow over the industry that employs about 37,000 people here. A spokesperson for Gateway Casinos, Tanya Gibara, did not respond to questions from Star Metro about how, if at all, the report has impacted the business. Gibara said the key issue in the strike was compensation, calling the union's expectations of wage increases of 60% or more not reasonable for any business. "We want to get our unionized employees back to work and remain committed to mediation," Gibara said in an emailed response. She said the company has proposed times for mediation within the next 2 weeks. "In the meantime, we have a responsibility to those that remain on the job and to our customers, therefore we're open." BCGEU President Stephanie Smith wasn't available for an interview Tuesday. But in a press release at the start of the strike, she said the Gateway employees were bargaining for living wages in line with what is offered at other BC casinos. The Living Wage for Families campaign puts the Kamloops living wage, the hourly wage, to full-time working adults would need to support themselves and two kids, at $17.31. Alex McKean is a Vancouver-based reporter covering wealth and work. Follow her on Twitter, @Alex_McKean.